This is the solution to WEX 131. All right, average value. So the formula is integral, well, 1 over b minus a integral a to b f of w dw. So then for this particular exercise, that would be 1 over 2 minus negative 1 integral negative 1 to 2, and then that thing there, 2w over w squared plus 4 exponent 3 dw. So, so 2 minus negative 1 is a third. I'll deal with that in a moment, but I guess I'll do a substitution here. So how about v is w squared plus 4, so dv is 2w dw. I'll go ahead and change the limits. V evaluated at negative 1, so using that v there, v evaluated at negative 1 would be 5. V evaluated at 2 is 8. Good. So then this would be a third integral 5 to 8 and then this then it would be 1 over v cubed dv. So better to write this as v to negative 3 would be a third, and then v to exponent negative 2 divided by negative 2, evaluated from 5 to 8. So now I'll simplify this a little bit. I will move the 2 out to be with the 3, so that would be a sixth. I'll do this in two steps, I guess. I'll write negative a sixth times 1 over v squared from 5 to 8, and then I'll get rid of the negative, by changing the order of the boundary of the evaluation. So now I'll do it. I'll leave the sixth factored out. So this would be 1 over 25, and then subtract 1 over 64. So that would be a sixth. Let's think about this. This has two fives, and that has two eighths. So do the cross multiply thing. So 25 times 64, so 1600. So this would be 64 minus 25 over 1600. So that would be 39. So 39. Sixth, 1600, and then 39 is divisible by 3. So dividing by 3. That'd be 13. And then the 2 with the with that one. So 13 over 3200. All right. Part B. It is 1 over 20 minus 0 integral 0 to 20 t exponential of negative 0.02 t dt. And this one's going to require integration by parts. So we'll label all the factors with their integration by parts label. So that's an algebraic factor, and this is an exponential factor. And remember that in integration by parts, the labeling is LAE, and you choose the one that comes first. So our choice for U is going to be that T. So U is T, and dV is then everything else. Exponential of negative 0.02 T dt. So then from U we can get dU is dt, and from dV we can anti-differentiate to get V. So that'll be exponential of negative 0.02 t over negative 0.02. Dividing by 0.02 is the same as multiplying by 50. So V is going to be negative 50 exponential negative 0.02 t. As a result, this will be 1 over 20 multiply integral 0 to 20. Whoops. That's not right. We're doing integration by parts. So this will be 1 over 20, and then now UV, so UV, T, and then multiplied by negative 50 exponential of negative 0.02 T, and we're going to want to evaluate that, boundary evaluate that. From 0 to 20. Now subtract integral 0 to 20 v du, so that'd be negative 50 exponential negative 0.02 t dt. This square bracket like that. All right. So then now this, I'll simplify this a little bit. I'll use this negative there to change the order of the boundary evaluation. So this will be 1 over 20. And then I'll write it as 50t exponential of negative 0.02 t from 0 to 20, and then add by exponential of negative 0.02 t dt. So that'll be a 20th. And then for this boundary evaluation, because I almost didn't notice. So when I changed this negative, I dropped it, so that and to do that, that means that I changed the boundary evaluation order to that. Okay, so then the at zero, that would be a zero, and then subtract all of that at 20. So 20 times 50, that'd be 1,000. And then multiply by exponential of negative, and multiplying that by 20, so that'd be 4 and shift, so that's 0.4. Okay, so that's the boundary evaluation. And now the antiderivative of that would be 50, and then exponential of negative 0.02t, and then divide by negative 0.02, and all of that evaluated from 0 to 20, and then end the square parentheses. It's a little crowded over there. All right. So then I'll simplify that a little bit. So that's 1 over 20. That 0 I'll just drop. So then this will be 1,000 times exponential of negative 0.4. Now, again, this division by 0.02 is multiplication by 50. So I'll say plus 2,500. And then this negative, I'll use it to, I'll spend it by reversing the order of the boundary evaluation. So exponential of negative 0.02t, and then all of that boundary evaluate 20 to 0. So that'll be a 20th multiplied by 1,000 exponential negative 0.4, then now plus 2,500, and now evaluate this. So when you plug in 0, you get 1, which is the exponential of 0, and then subtract exponential of negative 0.4. All right. So then that becomes a 20th. And so now this is saying there's 1,000 of these, because that's 1,000, and then 2,500 of negative 2,500 of those. So carrying that out, that gives you 2,500, and then subtract 1,500 exponential of negative 0.4, and then multiplying the 20th, the 1/20th in. So that'd be the 0 there causes a shift, and then divide by 2. So that'd be 125. And then subtract, divide by 2 and shift. So that'd be 75 exponential of negative 0.4. So that's the exact answer. And then typing that into the calculator, 74.72 59 9655. That's all the digits my calculator produces.